people have always looked to the stars for hope and inspiration. At Bridgewater State College, we have integrated our proud tradition of excellence in education with the development of opportunities to enrich the lives of our students and the fabric of society. This constellation of activity has become symbolic of our star student body reaching out, making a difference, and serving the community. Our college motto, not to be ministered unto, but to minister, has taken on added value as our students become more complete and caring citizens, giving back to our community, a community which for generations has been a generous supporter of public higher education. Whether it is mentoring, building, counseling, seeking solutions, or shedding some light on difficult situations, our students are there. Whether these programs are formally organized by our newly created Community Service Center or emerge spontaneously, our students are there. Tonight, we will take a look at two programs that symbolize the commitment of our campus community to the cities and towns around us. One is brand new to the college and the Commonwealth, while the other represents one of our longest-running endeavors. The Massachusetts Aggression Reduction Center, or MARC, is a growing partnership between our faculty and students, law enforcement officials, and K-12 educators. BSC student facilitators apply academic knowledge and professional training to lead positive motivational discussions about bullying in school districts across the state. As the Massachusetts Attorney General's office recently noted, MARC is uniquely qualified to assist schools and teachers and is providing critically needed services not otherwise available that meet a widespread need in Massachusetts.
What we really want to do is we want to know what the kids think about what are the problems that they face in school. And we find that a lot of them are having the same types of problems with diversity and sexuality and cliques. And actually we also found that there were some problems with teachers not responding to some people getting picked on or being mistreated or labeled or generalized in a certain way. So we, the facilitators, get to help because they tend to talk to us more than if they were talking to another teacher or a professor or adult of some sort, but they feel more comfortable to open up to us and talk to us about what they're really feeling about what's happening at their schools. So our goal is to help them to think about it more, recognize the problems, and come up with ideas to resolve the problems and hopefully make their school experience a lot better. We're a program that approaches anti-bullying, but not just physical abuse, but mainly emotional and psychological abuse. And I think it's so important because people never really think about the kind of impact that has on students, especially such young, impressionable kids, you know, and they don't realize how much it stays with them for the rest of their lives. And if people don't attack this problem now, it's just going to get worse, and it stems into bigger problems that we're having in our community now. So I think it's great that we're attacking this at such an early age, all the way down to elementary school, and I'm so glad to be a part of it.
How do you sum up the dedication of over 125 students each semester from various disciplines who give of themselves to bring meaning and help to nearly 60 children with physical disabilities and self-esteem needs? Through CPDC, a program that the Dana-Farber Cancer Institute has described as remarkable and inspiring. Not only is the service your program provides to the children immensely important, but the ability to foster a sense of volunteerism, compassion, and education in such a motivated group of students will no doubt provide tremendous rewards for the students and their communities for the rest of their lives.
You have a lot of love in the environment between the clinicians and the kids, and also between the clinicians and just everybody involved. It's really a great thing. It's really an ideal environment. I love it because you go in there, everyone's smiling, everyone's helping each other out, and it's just really the way the world should work. I mean, ideally, you know, so it's a great place to be. But I think it comes back to just helping someone who is also, quote unquote, less fortunate. They are at a disadvantage. And I know personally, that makes me want to help someone even more when they have less. And I think a lot of the clinicians feel the same way. I've dealt with kids in the past with learning disabilities and things of that nature. I didn't really see the other aspect as far as the parent side of things, where I have a much greater appreciation now for the parents than I did before, because I see how it's a challenging experience to have to bring up a child at a disadvantage. I've seen it, you know, with my parents, but I've also seen it with the mother of the child I've been working with. And I can, she's an angel. She really is. She's an angel on earth. The way she deals with him, and she makes him so happy. And I also see the way he makes her very happy too. And it's a great thing.
Isn't it reassuring to see so many of our young people volunteering their time? You know, when I was a student here in the 1980s, I too was a volunteer at clinic, and it was very difficult to get up on those weekend mornings. But you know what? Just to see the face of that little boy with cerebral palsy when I walked into the room as we would play kickball and dodgeball and swim in the pool, and the whole time here he is thinking he's having fun. And at the same time, we are teaching him very important things about his motor skills. And you know, his parents would say to us all the time, this is the highlight of his week. But what they didn't realize, it was the highlight of our week too. You know, we here in Bridgewater know that the real stars are not on TV, they're not in the movies, they're in our homes, in our community, they're in this very room tonight. It's people like you that are making the difference. You are the star. Making a difference at BSC, I'm David Robichaux. Thank you for joining us.